Captain Marvel was the very first movie to ever have a woman in it. We understand this. Captain Marvel was the very first movie to ever be opened in March, and look how awesome it did. They always try to find some sort of goal or some sort of achievement that really doesn't matter for shit, and they'd like to announce it. Not to mention that, really, DC movies, man, they just love to shit all over DC movies. And it surprises me that this happens even as much as it does. Well, in this instance, they came out with this little article that says that Captain Marvel passes the Dark Knight of all things.
Take that in, ladies and gentlemen. That is where we are.
Well, my thinking is, no, it didn't. They're like, oh, the Dark Knight is passing. It has got to say, oh my gosh, it's the best movie of all time. Captain Marvel. Captain Marvel will make you grow balls. You know, it just I'm like, guys, come on. No, it didn't. There's no way in hell it passed the Dark Knight. And of course, they're talking about a movie that's like 10 years old. They're talking about DC versus Marvel, which I'm fine with pushing the DC versus Marvel thing. I do it myself.
That's what we're all waiting for. We're all waiting for the day when DC and Marvel can be on fairly equal footing so they can actually, honest to goodness, duke it out like they always did in the comics.
Yeah. The thing is, and here it is, it says, Marvel continues to make history with Captain Marvel starring Brie Larson as the film has officially managed to over $100 billion, and now it topped the box office take of Christopher Nolan's Dark Knight. And it goes on to say, with a current total of $1,037,000,000, the film, which introduces blah, 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 yada, yada, it grossed $1 billion. It sits behind Captain America Civil War at 1.153, is the seventh highest grossing film in the MCU, and has now managed to pass the worldwide take of Christopher Nolan's The Dark Knight in its fifth weekend in the box office. And I'm thinking, you know what? You're missing one big detail. Do you know what it is?
Inflation.
Hey-o, there you go. I was thinking, wait a second. No.
Dark Knight made $1 billion in 2009 dollars, which...
But, yeah.
And there's another layer here, if I can go on a little bit of a side thing, which is to say, think of where the comic book genre was in terms of people's like stigma against it 10 years ago.
Yeah, that was before the takeoff of the Marvel universe. That was before it was the cool thing.
Yeah, and think about how far we've come and how easy it is, or how comparatively easier it is for a comic book movie to just pass, you know, $500 million. So saying making this comparison is taking out a little bit of the context, and that's kind of important, because Dark Knight made $1 billion when, for one thing, very few movies made $1 billion, period, and for another, it was when the comic book genre was still going full stigma of those could never conceivably be art.
The Dark Knight and Iron Man were the start of acceptance. Of real acceptance in the superhero movie genre. And now here's adjusted gross for The Dark Knight is $670,649,000. That's domestic. So Captain Marvel ain't beat shit. If you want to put it up side by side in modern dollars, and it's now it might beat it worldwide. Oh wait, that's unadjusted. Sorry, I was wrong. Yeah, it's got it. So yeah, it ain't. It's not beating shit. And I'm sorry, it's already number five on the top on the top five of the week. It's not going to be doing anything. It's dropped. It's done a great amount of business. I'm not going to put it down for that. But here's the thing, and I want to get into this just a little bit. Shazam came out, of course. It's grosses is here. It made $154 million worldwide, but it made $159 million worldwide. It made $54
million. Domestic.
Yeah, which made it above what their what its
projection
was to be. Yeah, thank you for the word. I appreciate that. Fragminion saying, I'm going to say it. Disney has probably put $500 million of its own money into ghost buying seats for the movie. We've seen it. We've seen that going on. So I wouldn't doubt it.
Now, I honestly hope.
Hey, Kevin, you. What's up?
Go ahead. I hope genuinely that Shazam makes over $1 billion or at least over 900, because
it's not going to.
If it can manage that, though, that will soundly put it above BVS, and it will officially solidify to Warner Brothers. This is the kind of tone we want, not the fucking grim and gritty for no reason tone. Which is
I would love for it to do that.
Work because the new Joker movie looks freaking amazing.
I would love for it to do that, but it's worldwide gross. In China, it didn't do as well. Mm-hmm. So I would see it probably topping about 500 is what I'm thinking. Maybe six.
The biggest problem is that it came out at the absolute most packed time and the worst conceivable time for it, because you've got Hellboy next week, which
that's not competition.
It's not really competition, but it is, you know, still in the comic book genre there.
That's competition for our dollars as comic book geeks, but it's not. Joe Normal isn't going, Shazam or because they're two different tones, two different ratings.
And then of course, 3 weeks from now, which hopefully Shazam will stay at number one for all three of those weeks, we have, you know, Avengers Endgame.
Yeah.
My biggest hope is that it will have minuscule drops from week to week. And that when Endgame comes out, it will be number two for the majority of the time that Endgame is in theaters. If it can manage that, then it could honestly get to around like Wonder Woman or Aquaman levels, and that would be good.
Yeah. Here's a question. Do you think that, as Fragminion is saying, that hardcore Marvel fans are going to intentionally skip Shazam because they are shill?
No.
You don't think so?
No, because the majority of people that dislike DC movies disliked DC as imagined by Zack Snyder. I think honestly, I mean, look at Aquaman of all things made
$1 billion. Yeah,
and that was during
Aquaman. Aquaman made most of its billion overseas.
This is true. This is a fair point. But it also made it during a time when Mary Poppins 2 was in theaters and Bumblebee and a bunch of other holiday blockbusters. So I have hope for Shazam, just the domestic and European box office needs to do a little bit more of the heavy lifting. The good news is it made a bunch of money that I wasn't expecting it to make in Europe in its first week. So if it can stay above 100 million in its second weekend in the European market, then we could still see some. It could still at the very least beat Justice League and maybe Suicide Squad, and I think that would be enough to solidify it.
The article I was reading goes to say that the projections were 40 to 45 million, with a few outlets going all the way up to 50. This guy was convinced. After I saw Shazam, I really thought, oh, wow, this might actually make 100. But no, it didn't, because word of mouth, I have not heard one person badmouth this. I think the worst I got was, well, this isn't my Shazam, because my Shazam had Uncle Dudley and it had, which I can understand. Yeah, this is the new 52, but it's still such a fun film. That it really is.
Yeah, and it does have a very coveted, I think it's A- cinema score, so it's getting good word of mouth. And this is one of the few times when the honest critics on like YouTube and such agree with the critics of the Rotten Tomatoes bet. Like it has what, a 91 on Rotten Tomatoes right now. So this is why I'm hoping it stays like in the 40s in its second weekend domestically, and it makes like 100 in the European market.
Well, as it's
Next
being
year.
said, it does need it's who's saying it? I saw it in the Tishana was talk about she read the Shazam needs to make 270 million to make a profit. That's worldwide, of course, and it's already 159. It's going to do that. My guess it's got I think it's going to stop around 5, maybe 6. Shazam needs to, and the writer's already talking about a sequel, which is not happening with Captain Marvel, I noticed. So that's interesting to me. And it might be the whole Star Wars Last Jedi thing. You know, she's made a lot of money, but she's not getting a lot of good press. Captain Marvel isn't getting a lot of love from people.
It's also that the majority of her box office, if we're entirely honest, comes from her being the holdover for Avengers Endgame.
Yeah,
Everything,
like it's the one right before it.
yeah, all the like casual Marvel fanboys are seeing it because they want to see where she's gonna stand in Endgame, and then once she doesn't have the big event to lead up to or jump off of.
Yeah, so we're
We
really going to
know
see
how far it's going to fall
the
there.
popularity of Captain Marvel is really going to be told to us in Captain Marvel 2, whatever it's going to
Yeah.
be.
And
Because that
it's especially true for.
Endgame is untouchable. Endgame is untouchable. That's going to be I've predicted, I said before when we were on the Disney stream, I'll say it again right here. Endgame, I am fully confident that that's going to be the highest grossing film of all time, and it's going to pass $3 billion.
I really, really hope so. I would love to see Endgame be the one to cross 3 billion under the proviso that it's as good as it looks and better and as good or better than Infinity War.
Infinity War. Yeah, I agree. I agree. I'm very happy that Shazam is doing as well as it did. It didn't have the budget that a lot of comic book movies have,
Yeah,
especially the DC movies. And that's why, even though it's only 159 million, which is a lot of superhero films opening weekend, as I mean, like they're opening, like they not overseas is what I'm saying. Is that's their domestic weekend gross. It still doesn't, it doesn't need it. So
Yeah,
I'm not feeling bad about this. I think it's done very well, and I've already heard talks about a sequel. I've heard people are excited about this. Haven't heard bad word of mouth. It, like you said, it's got a high rating, a high user rating on Rotten Tomatoes. So yeah, everything's looking coming up roses for Shazam.
And it deserves it because that movie is just it's
That's a lot of
phenomenal.
fun. It really is. I felt like when I came out of Superman, it returns. It's just amazing.
It also reminded me of a lot of like 80s kids movies, like Goonies and Big and Big especially, but that was an intentional kind of homage it did. But there's a lot of like it feels a lot like an 80s movie out of time,
Yeah.
with obviously better effects. And I think that's gonna be its biggest selling point, 'cause there's so many 80s kids and 90s kids and even kids that grew up in the 2000s that grew up on those movies, that this tone it has is gonna, I think, be a big selling point for it.
So there you go, guys. That is a lively discussion. I kind of enjoyed it. I would like to thank all of our patrons and Ko-Fi sponsors, including our new sponsor, Shyla Best. Thank you very much for joining the family. What do you guys think? I mean, they're saying Captain Marvel beat Dark Knight. They're trying to come up with any dubious achievement that they could think of. Once again, I think because if you adjust for inflation, Dark Knight's still winning, and I don't think Captain Marvel's going to make $500 million. I really don't. Anyway, what do you think? Let me know in the comments below. Don't forget to click like, share, subscribe, hit that notification bell. Cool things happen around these parts. Would hate for you to miss anything. And if you do like the video, please click on one of the boxes that are popping right around here and enjoy another one. You might like it as well. I'd like to thank everybody who's already done that, and to everyone, all of our true believers. Thank you very, very much for watching.